Hello everyone. Now our next chapter is chapter number 3, which is yoga and lifestyle. So this chapter is also very interesting because it will give you deep knowledge about various yoga asanas which will help in curing your lifestyle diseases and which will help you, and you can also help your loved ones. Okay, so first of all you should know what is asana. Asana is to sit in a comfortable position for a long time and for everlasting time or for a prolonged time. That is called an asana. Okay? So asanas are used as a preventive measures which provides these physiological benefits which will help us, ultimately help us in avoiding various lifestyle diseases. Lifestyle diseases are obesity, diabetes, back pain, asthma and hypertension. These are the basic lifestyle diseases which usually everyone is facing. So this chapter will help you how to cure this by practicing the yoga asanas. So the first benefit of doing yoga regularly is bones and joints become strong. By practicing yoga regularly, it will help you to make your bones, cartilage and ligaments very strong. And even yoga helps children to increase their height. And joints become able to bear more pressure. And it will also increases the flexibility of the joints and the spine. And postural deformities can be prevented or corrected by practicing yoga regularly. And the last one is few problems like cervical, back pain, shatika. These can be cured or can be controlled up to some level. So this was the first benefit. Another benefit is muscles become strong. So by practicing yoga regularly, the muscles of the body become strong, the efficiency of the muscle increases, which helps in reducing the accumulation of fat in the body. Next is respiratory organs become efficient, because yoga is involved with lots of breathing exercises. So where breath comes, respiratory organs involves already. So yoga helps in making the respiratory system more efficient. How? The vital air capacity increases by practicing yoga. You know, the volume, the air which we inhale and the air which we exhale, that capacity increases, and the size of the lung and chest also increases, because again it is related with the breathing exercises. Next is willpower becomes strong. We get a confidence that we can do all type of asanas comfortably. So that willpower increases by a regular practice of yoga. Next is, because it is related to respiration, so it will cure cough, asthma and trachea cancer. You can get a good benefit out of these asanas. Number third is immune system is strengthened. Nowadays, you are seeing that coronavirus is affecting everybody. So if you will practice yoga asana regularly, it will strengthen your immune system, as the body become less prone to various communicable diseases like flu or hepatitis or this coronavirus. Fifth one is blood circulation become normal, because when we'll do yoga, it affects our blood circulation. How? Stroke volume increases, cardiac output increases, and blood circulation improves, our blood pressure becomes normal, blood cholesterol decreases, and lactic acid formation reduce, or that lactic acids excrete from the muscles, and which will affect in lower down the fatigue of the body. So by practicing yoga asanas, you will get so many benefits. There are 9-10 benefits given in the book, but 5 are enough. So, and these points are also very much enough. You can memorize it and you will be able to gain full marks. Okay, so after discussing about the benefits of asanas, let's talk about the lifestyle diseases. So I told you before also, there are 5 lifestyle diseases: obesity, diabetes, back pain, asthma and hypertension. Okay, so there are many asanas given in the book related to each lifestyle diseases. But I have made a short video or a short note for you, which will help you to memorize all the asanas. Okay, so I have picked common asanas. So it will become easy for you to learn, and you will be able to answer all the asanas which will help in curing lifestyle diseases. Like, can you see here? Ardha Hastendrasana and Bhujangasana, so much common in all the diseases, lifestyle diseases. Obesity mein Ardha Hastendrasana hai, diabetes mein bhi hai, back pain mein bhi hai, asthma or hypertension mein nahi hai. So I have picked common asanas. So I'll be explaining you these four asanas which will cover the complete chapter. Okay, the first lifestyle disease is obesity. So we'll be discussing about the obesity. What is obesity? Obesity is that condition of body in which the amount of fat increases up to the extreme level. Generally, question arises that what should be the ideal weight of an individual? How we are going to know that the person is obese or not? So if you want to calculate, if you want to know your body mass index, then you have to divide your body weight in kgs upon your height in meter square. Here is the formula. Body mass index formula is BMI, weight upon height. And this table will help you to know that are you at a normal body weight or you are obese or you are underweight. So if your BMI comes below 18.5, then you will be considered as a underweight and you will be taken into a obesity class 1. But if your BMI is in between 18.5 to 24.9, you will be considered as a normal body weight and you will be counted under the obesity class 2. And if it increases from 25 till 29.9, then you will be considered obese and then you will come under the obesity class 3. Okay, so the first asana to cure this lifestyle disease is Vajrasana. So we'll be studying about Vajrasana. We'll study about the procedure, like how to execute that particular asana. We'll be studying about the benefits, that what are the advantages to cure this lifestyle diseases, and we'll be studying about the contraindication. Contraindication is that physical condition which makes a particular pose inadvisable, like particular asanas will not be appropriate for particular people. They should not do that asana. Okay, so let's see what is the procedure of Vajrasana. Okay, the first asana is Vajrasana. The procedure is, it is a meditative asana. First of all, kneel down on the ground or floor. Then now place your palms of your hand on the knees. The upper body should be straight. At this time, the breathing should be deep, even and slow. Then expand your chest forward and pull your abdomen portion inward. So this is the procedure that how to execute this Vajrasana. It has many benefits. Number one is, it is helpful in improving concentration. It is helpful in curing back pain and chest disease. It enhances memory power and it cures the problems related to menstruation. Now the contradiction of this Vajrasana is, a person who is suffering from joint pain should not perform this asana. And number two is, the individual who have any spinal column, spinal problem, should not perform this asana. Second asana to cure obesity lifestyle diseases, Ardha Hastendrasana. The procedure is, first of all, extend your both legs forward. The right heel is kept under the left thigh and left leg is crossed over the right thigh. After that, hold the left toe with the right hand and turn your head and back to the left side. In this position, move the trunk sideways, then perform the same asana in a reverse position also. So this was the procedure. It has many benefits. Number one is, it keeps gallbladder and prostate gland healthy. It enhances the stretchability of back muscles. It elevates digestive ailments also. It has few contraindications also. Number one is, women who are 2 or 3 months pregnant should avoid this asana. And number two is, the individual who suffer from the peptic ulcer or hernia should perform this asana only under the expert guidance. Okay, so second lifestyle disease is diabetes. So what happens in diabetes? In diabetes, it causes sugar to build up in our bloodstream instead of being used by our cells in our body. So there are two types of diabetes, type 1 and type 2. In type 1 diabetes, the pancreatic glands does not produce insulin and hence the insulin injection is required for its treatment. In type 2 diabetes, the body does not produce sufficient amount of insulin hormone. So there are frequent cases of type 2 diabetes and cases of type 1 diabetes is very rare. So tiredness, like a feeling of tiredness and blur vision and urge to urinate frequently, numbness in hands and feet and blur vision and excessive weight gain, weight loss or unhealing wounds are the common symptoms of this diabetes. So you can cure this diabetes or you can control this diabetes also with the help of two asanas. One is Ardhamastendra Asana and another is Bhujangasana. Ardhamastendra Asana is already explained you in previous lifestyle disease. I'll be explaining you the other asana, which is Bhujangasana. Next asana is Bhujangasana. So let me explain you the procedure of executing this asana. First of all, lie down on the belly on the ground. Keep your hands near the shoulders. Keep your legs close together. Now straighten up your arms slowly. Raise the chest. Your head should turn backward. Keep this position for some time. In this asana, the shape of the body remains like a snake. That is why it is called a Bhujangasana. You can repeat this asana 4 to 5 times. It has few benefits. Number one is it elevates obesity. It provides strength and agility. It cures the disorder of urinary bladder. It cures the disease of liver. It has few contraindications also. Number one is this asana should be avoided by the individual who suffer from hernia, back injuries, headaches and recent abdominal surgeries. Pregnant women should not perform this asana. Okay, so next lifestyle disease is back pain. So the pain which is felt at the back is usually originate from the bones, joints, muscles, nerves, etc. So our spinal cord is divided into three regions: cervical region, thoracic region and lumbar region. So this back pain can be in any of the region. It can be spontaneous, it can be chronic and it can be constantly affecting the one region or maybe radiate to other parts of the body like arms, legs or hip. So our body bear this back pain because of our bad personal health habits like overweight and lack of physical exercises or activities in our life, excessive smoking, lack of flexibility or undue stress on the back. So these can be prevented or cured with the help of two asanas, which are Ardhamastendra Asana and Bhujangasana. I have already explained you both the asanas. Next lifestyle disease is asthma. Asthma is a lung disease in which airways become blocked and narrow, which cause difficulty in breathing. In asthma, the airways swell up and produce extra mucus. It generally leads to wheezing, coughing, whistling and shortness of breath. And coughing generally occurs at night or early in the morning. Asthma can be prevented or cured with the help of two asanas. One is Bhujangasana, which I have already explained you. Another is Paschimotta Asana. So let me explain you the procedure, benefits and contraindication of Paschimotta Asana. The procedure of Paschimotta Asana is sit on the ground with legs forward. Then hold the toes of your feet with the fingers of both hands. Then breathe out slowly and try to touch the knees with your forehead. After that, breathe in slowly. Raise your head upward and come to the prior position. Perform this asana at least 10 to 12 times. The benefits of this asana are it cures gas trouble, it is good remedy for constipation, it reduces obesity and vertebral columns become flexible and healthy. The contraindications of this asana is avoid doing this asana if you suffer from asthma or any respiratory disease. If you have any back or spinal problem, make sure that you perform this asana only under expert
guidance.
Last lifestyle disease is hypertension. Hypertension is increased blood pressure. When the heart contracts, it pushes blood through blood vessels and consequently the blood pressure increases in arteries. So this pressure is called systolic blood pressure, which is represented by first number. And the pressure between two heartbeats is called diastolic blood pressure, which is represented by the bottom or second number. The normal blood pressure of an individual is considered 120 by 80 mmHg, which is milliliter of mercury. A person whose blood pressure goes beyond to this reading is said to be having hypertension. And this hypertension can be prevented or cured with the help of two asanas. One is Vajrasana and another is Bhujangasana. And I have already explained you both the asanas. This we have finished lifestyle diseases and the asanas associated with it. Now, from the exam point of view, I want you to go through two more asanas, which is Pavan Muktasana and Tadasana. And the following slides will give you detailed knowledge about the asanas. So here we have ended the chapter number 3, which is Yoga and Lifestyle. Hope you have understood it. Please go through the assignment given in your email group. Thank you so much.